Okay, this is the second video about my Alex wheelchair. And right now I'm going to show you, I'm going to zoom into this problem with this spring right here first. You can see the pictures on the website. So you can see that this tie down is really long. And this wheel right here goes up and down because it's got that kind of suspension. The front goes up and down. The whole chair rocks. It's meant to give you a smooth ride. So when you're sitting in a bus, the whole chair wants to rock because it's sitting on springs. All these four wheels are on springs. And so this tie down needs to be above the suspension to the area of the chair that's solid, that doesn't move. And this tie down needs to be made out of really, really solid, rigid forged steel that doesn't move. Because right now this thing, this loop tie down just bounces up and down. And I'm leaning against a wall here. And I'm not very healthy and I don't stand for very long. So let's see, I tried to do this before. No, I can't do it that way, just a second. Okay, I'm gonna zoom out so I don't lose the focus. This moves up and down really, really, really easy. So when you consider that the chair is around, you know, 400 pounds, 500 pounds, and then my weight, it's altogether it's about 800 pounds. You're in a moving vehicle, you're sitting in a chair, and you're sitting up really, really high in this chair. So this backrest doesn't really offer any kind of lateral support sideways, so that when the bus is moving, this chair is rocking violently and I'm sliding back and forth in this chair, and I've got a broken back and a lot of broken ribs, and this is why they got me a chair with soft suspension, because of my condition. So the backrest won't work. When I talked to the guy that sold us the chair, he said, oh, there's nothing that can be done, there's no other backrest available, and there are other ones, but they just don't want to put one on there. And then I'll show you this headrest. This headrest is really wide, it's practically flat, and so when I'm being jolted back and forth in this chair, my head is just bouncing back and forth. I wear a neck brace. So basically what's happened now with this chair is being so poorly built, I can't go anywhere on a bus. I can't go anywhere by any kind of vehicle. I'm limited with the weather conditions, the sidewalk. And now I'm going to show you the front end here, okay? Right here is a pivot point. This arm goes up and down. This is a spring right here. So when you're driving and you hit bumps, this caster goes up and down, and so does that one. And so these do these back wheels. So what is happening with this chair is that if my weight shifts and all the weight goes on that caster on this side, this caster loses the contact with the ground and it starts vibrating, turning. It starts turning back and forth. It starts flopping back and forth like you would see on a shopping cart. So, and this is a huge caster. So you're looking at a big giant piece of steel and rubber that's bouncing back and forth. And when that happens, the control arm actually drops down lower because the wheel is going backwards. And it shakes the whole chair really violently for up to 20 seconds. And you can't control the chair when it's doing that. You have to just let go of the controller on the chair and you have to stop and wait until this thing stops vibrating, because it shakes the whole chair, shakes that arm, and it's going to destroy the chair. And not only that, it's extremely violent on my body, and it's very painful. And when that chair does that, you could be crossing the street, you could be anywhere, you lose control of the chair, you could be on a sidewalk, you can end up falling over the curb and onto the street, or you could run over somebody. You have absolutely no control over the chair when this happens. And what we have here is we have some serious design flaws in this chair, and there are other problems with this chair that I'm going to do another video about to explain to you. But one of the reasons why this is going on in this country of Canada is because, unlike Europe and the USA or other countries, we don't have any rules, regulations, licensing, inspections, certification, accountability. Your list doesn't end. You become disabled in this town and you are on your own. They don't give a damn about you. And I fought for years to get this more modern wheelchair so that I could ride around without being in horrific pain and endangering my life. I have a broken spine with my T8 compressed by 90%, which is unheard of, meaning that I'm in two pieces. And being violently jolted around could sever my spinal cord any time and leave me paralyzed. And believe me, it would cost the system a lot more money. And my life would be miserable if I became paralyzed. So now you've seen the problem with the suspension on this chair. Now I'm going to tell you one more thing. There's a lot of people that are criminally negligent in what they're doing to me, because they've been told, they've been advised, they're aware, and they just don't care that they're endangering my life. and that makes them criminally negligent. They can't plead ignorance in a court of law and say they didn't know, because I've published previous articles describing this problem. Right now, I'm going to do a little bit of a zoom for you, so you can see the front loop. And this front loop is just basically spring steel. And it looks like it's really solidly attached, but it's not, because when it's tied down on the bus, this thing goes up and down too. Everything in this chair moves. I did in the picture, this wheel well here. Let me show you something. You're riding down the sidewalk and you're hitting all the little cracks in the sidewalks, and they're everywhere. Well, this thing, I trimmed it trying to bring down the noise level. And listen to this. This is what it does all day long when I'm riding around. And it's really loud when you're going down the sidewalk. You know, you would think that they would have attached that really solidly, so it wouldn't be doing this. But no, they didn't do that. Now, I'm going to show you the controller. And I'm going to do another video after this one describing the problems that I have with this controller. Okay, first of all, I'm going to back up so I can zoom in. I took the button off, okay? You saw me reaching over on the other side of my chair to turn on the chair. I put silicone over it. Right there, when this chair is manufactured, I'm going to back up more to try to zoom in. So right there where that silicone is where the power switch used to be. And I can't believe that anybody would be so stupid to design a wheelchair like that. Because when you're disabled, you have real difficulties moving. You're trying to get into the chair and you're reaching back with your hands trying to lean on something. Or your coat. Anyway, the button that they had on there, that's the power button. And every time you get in out of the chair, your coat, your scarf, your hands, anything would touch. You just barely had to touch that button and the chair would turn on. So you're reaching back. You're trying to reach because you can't see behind you. You put your hand on the controller to see where it's at, and it turns on the chair, and your hand touches the controller, and you get run over by the chair. You know, I can't believe that these people don't have any sense to put that power switch somewhere, you know, out of the way, or put a cover over it so that it doesn't accidentally get turned on. And you know, this chair here almost ran me over twice. So I told them I can't have that switch there, so I disconnected, and they put another switch in. But that should have never been manufactured like that. So right now, you've got another safety hazard that's really serious. You've got the suspension problems. And all this is happening because, unlike cars, and people, he's realized that wheelchairs are more expensive than cars. This two-wheel chair is around $15,000. It can go up a lot higher, this chair, depending on the modifications. And this can go up to $40,000. You tell me why it is that people who sell wheelchairs don't have to abide by the same laws that car dealerships have to. You go out and spend $15,000 on a car, and you've got problems or anything else, they bend over backwards to protect you or to help you to fix the vehicle. They have warranties, they have guarantees, they have everything, and they have laws to protect the consumer. So, you know, you get a $15,000 car, you get excellent treatment. You get excellent service from the people. Otherwise, they can lose their license to operate. But no, you get a wheelchair, and you're on your own. They don't give a damn. There's no quality checking. There's no licensing. There's no fines. There's nothing. They treat people like garbage. And I keep telling them that this electric wheelchair is just as important as any motorized vehicle that you see out on the street. But it's even more dangerous because I'm on the sidewalk and I can move pretty fast. This chair is about 800 pounds, and when it's going, it's like 3,000 pounds hitting you. So you got a motorized vehicle driving down the sidewalk that loses control when the caster goes. And I'm going to do another video describing to you the problems with that controller and the electronics in it. So I don't want to make these videos more than, you know, about 10 minutes. So anyway, that's another serious problem with this chair. And there's more. I mean, you know, the reason why there's all these design flaws is because in Canada, we have no regulations. They can permit people to sell anything to anybody that's disabled and nobody cares. The disabled have absolutely no rights in this country. You become disabled and you lose all your rights. You know, everybody else in society is protected with every imaginable civil law and criminal law and everything else to protect you so you don't get injured by negligence or incompetence or just plain outright theft. Well, the whole industry here is so corrupt. The government is corrupt. Everybody's corrupt. And I've been fighting for this for years. And you know what? They just don't care and they just don't listen. Now I'm in court and I'm starting a human rights trial. And it's going to be a doozy because I have all my documents, all my articles have been published online, photos, videos, everything they've done to me. And whenever you fight for your rights in Nova Scotia and Halifax, the backstabbing government and people here, they talk behind your back, they slander you, they go around talking to people on the street. Anyway, they attack you and they go after you and they destroy your life. And I, you know, they don't even draw the line of killing you, okay? Which they've tried to do to me. That's how I ended up in a wheelchair. Anyway, that's in the second video, and there's a third one coming up. Thank you for listening. And please get involved and help the people. And go to wheelchairrights.wordpress.com and get involved and help people that are disabled, because they need your help. Because one day you might become disabled.